Hello everyone, my name is Ryan Rudd and I'm a solutions engineer with the customer care team here at KNIME. And in this video, I hope to show you how to properly configure a Python environment on KNIME server in order to get Python related workflows running as expected on the server. To do this, we will be covering the following topics. First, observing the difference between running Python jobs locally and in the server. Secondly, the steps needed to configure a Python Conda environment. Then we will create a client profile on the server so it knows where to locate the newly created environment. And finally, we will test to see the results of our newly configured system. With that being said, let's look at our analytics platform where a workflow that has been developed and executed locally has ran successfully. The script very simply should output "Hello World" when executed, as we can see below. As a next step, you might want to upload this or any other type of Python related workflow to your KNIME server. To do this, we follow the process of right-clicking on the workflow and selecting Upload to Server, then resetting the workflow and selecting the location to upload. Once deployed, we should see it populate in our server mount point and can then right-click on the workflow and select Execute and finally press OK. After executing, we can open the job and see that the Python script node has failed to execute, with the reason being that in order for Python-based nodes to execute on the server, we first need to have Python installed on the server in a location that the executor can locate. To do this, we will now switch to our Windows-based KNIME server and follow the necessary steps to get Python enabled on this machine. The package manager that we will be using in this video will be Miniconda, which will include the Python installation and virtual environment packages. On this page, we are seeing the Conda installation links and will follow the next steps to get Miniconda installed on our Windows KNIME server. For this demonstration, I will go ahead and accept the default install options. These can also be changed after if necessary. After the Miniconda installation, we can press start and open the Anaconda prompt and type in Conda list to make sure our base installation was successful. Now that we see our base installed, the next step will be to create a Conda environment. First, we need to create a YAML file, which we can get from the following KNIME documentation and use this as the template to create our Conda environment. Upon pressing the link, we can use the following to copy and paste onto a notepad or the text editor of your choice. During this step, you can also add or delete certain packages you want as part of this virtual environment. The first line that we see is the name of the virtual environment, and I decided to change this to py3_KNIME prior to creating the environment. Once saved, we can go back to the Anaconda prompt and run the command conda env create -f in the path to the YAML file that we saved and then press enter. This will typically take a few minutes to resolve and create. As you can see, it prompts you to activate the environment, which is done with the following command. Upon executing, you can continue to install additional Python packages as your needs change over time. It is also worth noting that KNIME has a native node called the Conda Environment Propagation node that will more seamlessly manage your Conda environment through the respective Python workflow being ran. Now we can navigate the file explorer to the location of Miniconda and the newly created Conda environment, which will be important for the upcoming configurations. As our next step, we will want to create a client profile to show the executor where the Python environment lives on the server. To do this, the easiest way is to navigate over to our KNIME Analytics platform and export the preferences under File and Export Preferences. Then we will want to open this file up and search for Python. We will want to copy the highlighted lines because they will be used as a template over on the KNIME server. Now moving back to the server, we will want to navigate into the workflow repository, config folder, and finally into client profiles. Here we will want to create a Python folder. As you can see, mine has already been created, along with a copied version of the default.epf file inside the Python folder. Once the EPF file has been opened, we will paste the contents of the Python preferences that were copied from the analytics platform. The important thing, however, is that we will need to change out the directories of where Miniconda lives and our Conda environment, as mentioned previously. An important note, if you're using a Windows server, we will need to do a double backslash due to backslashes being considered an escape character. If not, we will get an error that the mentioned directory does not exist. Let's go ahead and save this file and exit. Then navigate to our executor workspace to locate the nime.ini file. Go ahead and open this file. However, before following, you will want to make sure that the following lines are already included. If not, you can include them yourself. Just make sure they are inserted before the vmargs argument. They also can be found in the NIME server documentation located here. Secondly, you will want to add a comma in the Python argument as highlighted to make sure that newly created client profile is read from and taken into account. Lastly, we will want to restart our services and then test this out. Now back on the analytics platform, we can try and run another job on our server as we tried previously. As we can see, our simple Python script has now run correctly. In summary, we showed how you can integrate Python onto your NIME server by utilizing Miniconda to spin up virtual environments. And finally, use client profiles to point the executor in the correct location to where the Python environments were located. Hopefully this video was helpful and I appreciate your time. Thanks.